Hi, I'm Anne McCarthy from Our Lady of the Rosary Cathedral in San Bernardino, California. Thanks for joining us on iGod today. Saints Cosmas and Damian were twin brothers born in Arabia, now modern-day Syria, around 270 AD. They had three younger brothers. Their father passed away while they were all quite young, so their mother was left to raise all five of them herself. Cosmas and Damian were educated in science and medicine and became physicians. They became very skilled and enthusiastic about their work, and they offered their services primarily near the Aegean Sea between Tarsus and Antioch. The following story about their work provides a meditation for our own lives. Cosmas and Damian saw in every patient a brother or sister in Christ. For this reason, they showed great charity to all and treated their patients to the best of their ability. Yet no matter how much care a patient required, neither Cosmas or Damian ever accepted any money for their services. For this reason, they were called the penniless ones. Every chance they had, the two saints told their patients about Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Because the people all loved these twin doctors, they listened to them willingly. Cosmas and Damian often brought health back to both the bodies and the souls of those who came to them for help. Saints Cosmas and Damian are the patrons of the city of Gaeta, Italy. It is believed that through their intercession, the city's population was spared during 18th century plague. These two saints were asked to renounce their faith, and they refused. So they were subjected to several means of torture before they were finally put to death. First, they were thrown into the sea with their hands and feet bound. But legend has it that a miracle occurred, and they got free and were able to swim ashore. Next, they tried to burn them at the stake, but the flames wouldn't touch them. After that, they tried to flog them, but the whips wouldn't touch them either. After a final demand that they renounce their Christian faith was refused, Saints Cosmas and Damian were decapitated. That day was September 27th in the year 287. Problem was, even after death, these two brothers still continued to heal those who prayed for their intercession. Even today, these saints have a following all over the world. In many countries, parades, celebrations, and festivals are held for them every year. In New York, in Utica, in the Diocese of Syracuse, the Church of St. Anthony and St. Agnes have held a festival since 1912 in their honor that has drawn thousands of people every year. This year, for the first time, because of the coronavirus, they had to cancel it. This is just one example. There are so many celebrations all over the world that we would be here all day if I listed them. St. Cosmas and Damian are regarded as the patrons of physicians, surgeons, and pharmacists, and are sometimes represented with medical emblems. St. Cosmas and Damian are included in the Litany of the Saints. The Litany of the Saints is one of the oldest prayers in continuous use in the Catholic Church. Forms of it were used in the East as early as the 3rd century, and the Litany as we know it today was largely in place by the time of Pope St. Gregory the Great. It is a moving appeal for help from many of our greatest saints, as well as for divine protection. You will usually hear it on Holy Saturday. St. Cosmas and Damian, pray for us. Let us pray. Dear Father, thank you for the example of St. Cosmas and St. Damian, reminding us to strictly observe the command of Jesus. Freely have you received, freely give. In Jesus' name, I thank you for all you freely give me every day. Amen.